Yes, I welcome you once again to the session. Now we'll continue from the last. What we have seen in the last? Yes, tell me your answers. Able to hear few? If you are keeping mum, why? Yes, irrigation, right? Irrigation and protection from weeds. Now, next we will be seeing about the harvesting. This is the important process. At the last, we are going to do it right. Harvesting. Harvesting is nothing but it is the process of cutting mature crops from the fields. The process of cutting mature crops from the field is called as harvesting. The process of cutting the crops from the field is called as, that is the mature crops. It is done with the help of sickle. This is called as sickle or by a harvester machine. This sickle is the traditional tool used. This sickle is the traditional tool used for harvesting, and this is the modern equipment, that is the harvester machine. Harvesting is done with the help of machines. Okay. Next, the process of separating grain seeds from the chaff. Chaff is nothing but this stem part from the grains. See here, this is the chaff and this is the grain. The process of separating grains from chaff is called as threshing. This is done with the help of combine. During the olden days, they used to do like this. Chaff is the nothing but the layer which covers the grain. Chaff is nothing but the layer which covers the grain. So the process of first we are doing harvesting. The plants are harvested, and then during olden days, first with the help of sickle, they used to beat it, and then they take the grains alone, and then they separate, right? They separate the chaff from the grain. This is the traditional method. But the modern, they have a combined harvester. That is, both the harvesting and the threshing are done with the same machine. Both the process of harvesting and threshing are done with the help of same machine. This is called as combined harvester. It has both harvester and threshing together. And the next one is winnowing. Okay, but this is, listen here, this can be done for a large scale of land. But the farmers with small holdings of land do the separation of grain and chaff by winnowing. That is used for the large scale production. But for the small scale production, they use winnowing. This is the winnowing machine. This is the traditional method. See, a lady is standing here. She has the grain along with husk and some other things inside this. And in the direction of the air, they used to shake that like this. Have you seen that? So when they are shaking like that, so this husk are of less weight compared to the grains. So they flow away and we get the grains. And this is the winnowing machine. And harvesting is celebrated like a big festival in many states. Harvesting is celebrated like a big festival like Pongal, Baisakhi and Bihu. Pongal, Baisakhi and then Bihu. Pongal is celebrated in where? Pongal is celebrated in Gujarat. Very good. Pongal is celebrated in Tamil Nadu. Pongal is celebrated in Tamil Nadu during the month of January. And this Baisakhi. What? Baisakhi. It is also the harvesting festival which is celebrated in Gujarat. This Baisakhi festival is celebrated in Gujarat by Sikh community people. And then this last one is the Bihu. Bihu is celebrated in Assam. Bihu is celebrated in Assam. They used to have their traditional dance there. And then all the peoples in the village, they used to cook together, eat, and then celebrate this Bihu festival. It is called as Maha Bihu. So these three are the festivals which are associated with the harvesting. Next, this is the last but the important, very very important step done to be done after harvesting, because proper storage is required for the crops. Proper storage must be done. So storage is an important step that is done after harvesting. It is done to protect the crop. Have you seen in your house? If not, go and see once in the kitchen. If there are some old grains or something, there would be small insects, something which is present there. So for to avoid this wastage of grains, proper storage must be done. It is done to protect crop grains from moisture, insects, rats and microorganisms. So how it is done, we'll consider it in the house. So properly these grains must be drained in the, dried in the sunlight. So when it is dried in the sunlight, the moisture content which is present in the grains would be evaporated and it can be stored for a long time. If the moisture content is not removed properly, then it leads to be storehouse for the insects, rats and microorganisms, etc. And grains are stored in metallic bins or jute bags. In houses, we used to store in jute bags, right? And then how do we get jute bags? From jute plant. And dried neem leaves. Neem is a good antibacterial, right? So it can be put inside the drains and kept it. So it can sustain for a long time. And in big godowns, granaries are used to see. These are all the sioles or granaries which are used to store the grains in large quantity. Okay. So here they use chemicals. In these granaries, they use certain types of chemicals to save them from this moisture, insects, etc. Then next one is, now we have seen, what we have seen up to is how we are getting the food from the plants. We are getting food only from plants or also from animals? Yes, we get food also from animals, right? So food is also obtained from animals. So that the animals are reared. Reared is nothing but they are given proper shelter, home, food and care, etc. Animals are reared at homes. Yes, in few houses there may be cattle, right? Like cow, hen, goat, sheep, etc. And then they are reared in farms in large quantity. Have to be, and these animals are to be provided with proper food, shelter and care. So this is called as animal husbandry. So food is also obtained not only from plants, but the food is also obtained from animals. So the proper caring must be given. So this type of rearing of animal is called as animal husbandry. Here you are able to see few pictures, right? It is milk, cow and then hen. What are the products which we are getting from it? We get milk from cow. From that milk we get curd, cheese, butter, etc. And from this hen we get egg. So we also grow not only this, we also grow goat, sheep, fish also. Yes. So this type of taking care of animals giving them proper food and shelter is called as animal husbandry. Clear? Up to this, we have come to an end of this lesson, crop protection and management. We have come to an end of the lesson, crop protection and management. First, we have seen what is meant by crops, right? And what are the types of crops based on seasons? They are kharif and then rabi crops, and based on the types of nutrition also they are classified. And then the steps which are involved in the agricultural practices are called agricultural practices. The activities which are involved are called agricultural practices. In that, first we have seen about soil preparation. What are the process in that soil preparation? Tilling. The loosening of soil is called as tilling, and we use plug, hoe, and then cultivator. Good. What are all the implements we use? Plug, hoe, and then cultivator. What is the second step? Good. Sowing. Yes. What are the two types in that? Funnel shaped equipment, that is the traditional method, and then seed drill, right? And then adding manures and fertilizers. We have seen how to prepare compost, vermicompost, right? And then advantages and disadvantages of manures and fertilizers. After that, what we have seen? Irrigation. Irrigation, what are the two methods? In irrigation, what are the two methods? Good. They are traditional and then modern. After that irrigation, what we have seen? Protecting from weeds. Yes? Proper protection must be. So, what is that process name? Weeding. And then weeds. And the chemical used is weedicide. What is the chemical used in weeding? 2,4 dichlorophenoxy, right? And then after that we have seen harvesting, combine harvester, yes, and then we have seen sickle. Combine harvester has both thresher and then harvester, and then winnowing we have seen. At the last, storage, which is good for storage at home, neem leaves. We have seen a recap. Now try to answer all these questions. The first step in growing crop is, let me see who is going to tell the answer first. Very good. Everyone are telling the answers, right? So, the first step in growing of crops is soil preparation. What is irrigation? What is irrigation? Give marks to yourself. Okay. What is irrigation? Yes. Good, good. The process of supplying water to the plants. Next question. Name some festivals associated with harvesting. Name some festivals associated with harvesting. Very good. Before I finish the question, you are ready to answer, right? Bihu, Baisakhi, and then Pongal. The process of loosening soil is called tilling. You are very enthusiastic up to the last, right? What are the methods of replenishing soil? Crop rotation. Very good. Animal husbandry. Now only we have seen. Yes. Tell me. So, rearing of animals with proper food and shelter. Next. So, you all like this slide, right? Homework. So, try to write answer for all these questions. This is your homework. Students, please don't hesitate to ask any doubts. If you ask any doubts, just post it in the group. I'll clear you. Okay? So, thanks for listening to the class patiently. Take care. Bye.